We are finally opening our engine rooms to
the
public.
That is so cool.
It's really awesome. Since we got the ship, people have been clamoring to get into these spaces. They are quite narrow, and it involves a lot of steep stairwells.
I was going to say, you know what? They're ladders, right?
Ladders, yes. So
how many decks down?
I couldn't even tell you. Many, many. It's the bowels of the ship. But because of the, because
of
this,
the
bowels of the ship, it's a guided experience. So it's
because you might not make it back up if you don't have.
Well, I've been several times, and it is amazing the scale.
So what are your knees look? Are they banged up on the ladders?
Not well. That's why.
How many steps do you use?
I don't know.
Do you slide down? That's what you're supposed to do.
We want to make it as welcoming an experience for everyone as possible. But the scale of this machinery that was needed in order to make this ship go, which was called a City at Sea, is astronomical. And then you imagine how hot it was down there. And the teamwork that was involved. You know, oftentimes these sailors had to work in unison in order to do certain operations. And it's really fascinating.
Really?
So I'd highly recommend
that.
Does it
stink?
No.
How'd you get to?
And we're getting more and more lighting. It's taken quite a while to open these spaces. We've had to go through a lot of safety regulations and, you know, drills and all sorts of things. So we're real excited. That's going to be June 18th. We're opening.
So is it a guy thing to really want to go look at a piston that's huge?
Oh, I don't know.
You like it?
I would think
too?
It would be an equal opportunity
really?
Experience.
Good date night?
Well,
date day?
Depends on what kind of date you're having.
Yeah, because you got another event coming up that really sounds cool.
Oh,
lock
yeah.
yourself up in the captain's cabin?
Yes, yes.
And see if you can get out?
We have created our own version of a very popular trend sweeping the world actually, of the escape room, where the premise is you're in a room, there are several themes, and you have to solve a series of clues and puzzles in order to get out. So you have 60 minutes to do it. The room contains all of the clues, you know, behind a picture frame or, you know, under sometimes.
So you go through the drawer, because now you just kind of walk through and you got the mannequin in it that scares the daylights out of you.
Right. Well, I'm not making any promises about mannequins, but.
But now you can go through the drawers and everything?
Well, some I'm imagining. So that should be really fun. So we are calling it Escape Ship Captain's Challenge. That is opening at the end of June, and we're hoping this will be, eventually we can do a different themed one in the Admiral's Cabin. The Captain's Cabin where the captain of the ship sort of conducted his important business, and there's a room where he slept off of like his dining.
Once all the big decisions were made, he slept.
Yes, yes, so that's going to be part of it too.
Because normally you just kind of peek in the
portholes.
Thank you. The portal. Now you can go in there and get locked in.
Yeah.
So.
And there's like a guide who kind of gives you the setup, gives you kind of the scenario.
Okay.
And then if you have trouble, they'll be.
Oh, okay. Because.
And then you're not really. I mean, it's not like you're going to spend the night there if you don't get out in it.
I mean, I would be fearful that somebody would be looking out the portal saying, "Let me out." But you got somebody that will let you out.
Yes.
Have you done it before?
No.
No.
I'm actually no good at puzzles.
So you went down 16 flights of steps to a.
I had to get some pictures.
Lower deck, but you haven't done the escape room.
Well, it's really cool because some of our guides.
Because I was going to try to get some secrets from you.
Well, some of our guides have done this kind of work, so they have all kinds of really great stories.
So, do they give you some inside scoop so we can have some answers? But I guess you want to be in the room for an hour. You don't want to be out of the room.
Oh, we're talking about escape ship, or we're talking about
yeah.
the.
No,
yes.
The one.
No, you have to be in the room for an hour. So it's a great group activity, actually.
Where yeah, you bring some friends.
Bring some friends, and it's fun. So it's going to be running Thursday through Sunday and sort of into the evening hours, so you can grab your work buddies and do some bonding and come after work and do it.
Cool. Team building.
Team building.
I mean, you're a strong team if you get locked up and can't get out.
Absolutely.
Okay. So that all starts the month of June.
Right.
And it's going to run through the whole summer?
Yes, yes, and possibly into the
Unless
fall.
That first group never gets out because you lost
right.
the key.
That's right. And then we'll have to use them for Halloween somehow, but
oh yeah. Okay, then you go into something serious, it sounds like.
Yes, well, we
for
have
all those in uniform who served
actually
is that serious?
We are really excited about this exhibit that's going to be installed in the wardroom, honoring Alan Dean, who was the first African-American officer to serve on the Wisconsin, and actually it's called Alan Dean Rising Above Bias. We have been talking to his wife and his daughter and getting artifacts to use in the exhibit, there's going to be a video component. And the more we learn about Alan Dean, the more remarkable a guy, you know, he's sort of becoming in our minds. So that's going to be, the wardroom is right where you're, it's the first interior space that you walk into when you come on the Battleship Wisconsin.
You know, I think it really is apropos because you've got, I mean, the Wisconsin had such a long lineage of service.
Right, right.
It, and we talk about it being a city on the sea. It brought all the issues of American cities onto the ship, too.
Yes, that's a really good point.
So what a great way to show honor.
So this should be fine. It's replacing the original exhibit when we opened the wardroom in 2010 that was devoted to John Warner, who was very instrumental in bringing the ship to Norfolk. But then, on the lighter side, we are bringing back the Fantail Film Festival.
That's going to be cool.
For two dates in July and two dates in August. And it gives you an opportunity to kind of watch movies the way the sailors during World War II did on the back of the ship, which we call the Fantail. So it's really a great, there never seems to be any bugs. There's a nice breeze. You bring a camp chair, you bring your family. It's $3, and you have this, you know, cool experience on the back of the ship.
Only I would think this way, but come July 9th, date night on the Wisconsin, July 9th.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you get yourself locked up, come a little early, get locked up in the ship's cabin, or the captain's tower.
And you're so relieved when you escape.
You're so relieved to get out to see Top Gun.
That's right.
Come on.
See a really macho
also,
movie. Yeah.
Well, then the next movie on the 23rd is Somebody Got Lost. Nemo got lost. You found her.
Right. And
now you're lost Dora in the movies.
There's a slight theme there because we do have clownfish in our Aquaria exhibit, too.
There you go. Always thinking ahead. And then Captain America, Winter Soldier. Who picked these movies? What? I mean, these are you know.
Well, it was, you know, it was selection.
There's a theme here.
Selection by committee.
Tarzan, is that the cartoon or the live action?
I think
one?
It's the live action one.
Yeah, there's a theme going there.
That's right. And then we're hoping, you know, adventure, you know, kind of get your pumping in some respect. But in case of rain, the movies are. They are moved to the Nauticus Theater. And speaking of the Nauticus Theater.
There you go. What a segue.
This summer, we're switching out our roster of movies. We're bringing back The Living Sea, which is narrated by Meryl Streep and features a score by Sting, which is in high def. But our new 3D movie is called Aircraft Carrier, which is so brand new. We haven't even gotten it yet. So we're excited to see it. And that'll just sort of run indefinitely.
Wow.
But people love our 3D movies, and they're included in regular Nauticus admission.
I mean, I can imagine an aircraft carrier in 3D.
Yeah, yeah, and apparently they take you through kind of sea and air operations as they're training, and it's supposed to be quite something.
And then there's still the old good old standby reliable stuff that you can go see on the way to these different adventures in both the Wisconsin and Nauticus.
Yes, actually, right outside our 3D theater, we've opened a mini exhibit called Norfolk Canyon. I don't know if you're familiar with Norfolk Canyon, but it's kind of like our version of the Grand Canyon off the coast of Virginia. And they've discovered all sorts of neat sea creatures that exist down there. And, you know, it's so deep down that they didn't think that life could.
In closing, what I have found, most of what you've talked about, you and I can have a blast with. So if you want to bring a kid, you can, but you don't have to.
Absolutely. Spy Ship, we're recommending for 14 and up. But you could certainly bring your little bitty and they could just sit there.
Get lost in the captain's quarters. That sounds awesome.
That's
Thanks
great.
A lot.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, when we come back, we have an answer for you. Have you ever been asked to speak to, 3,000 people? Stay tuned to find out how you can do it.